Kittl just got even more powerful with Flux AI. In this video, I'll be putting it to the test to see how really good it is for print-on-demand sellers. And if you get any value out of this video, make sure you give it a thumbs up. All right, so I'm logged into the back end of my Kittl account. So I'm gonna come over here, I'm at the homepage, and then if you scroll down right here, there's gonna say tools. You can go ahead and click on, what we're gonna do is go to the Flux AI. You can click right here to image generator, click that. Now what it's gonna do is gonna go ahead and open up the image generator, and we're gonna come over here to advanced, and we have DALL-E 3 or Flux 1.1 Pro. We're gonna go ahead and click on that. Now I'm just gonna break down of everything right here from the describe your image, right there, aspect ratio. This is all depending on how you wanna put your aspect ratio. I'm gonna go 1:1. Now if you wanna put it public or private, I'll just go ahead and put it public. And if you have your save styles, you can go ahead and click the one that you wanna do. If you want, right here, there's image styles that they provide to you. And you're gonna see right here the different image styles that you're gonna use. Now for the prompts right here, I'm gonna go ahead and leverage ChatGPT for this to give you an idea. If you have your own prompts, by all means, you can go ahead and use that, but I'm just gonna make it as simple as possible so you can understand of how to create a prompt. And then you can actually, just when it populates the prompt for you on ChatGPT, you can go ahead and you can leverage that prompt and then fix it how the way you want it to be done. Now I'm over here inside of ChatGPT. What we did was I went ahead and used a GPT back here, and I just typed in futuristic neon sneaker ad creative, and it went ahead and created me a prompt. Now, one thing I'm thinking about when it comes to this is when it's populating certain things, I think about like flyers, I'm thinking ads, I'm thinking storybook, even as far as like generating thumbnail ideas, okay? So it's realistic as far as you're gonna see an example in here and how it, what it creates and give you an idea. So think about how you're gonna use it to your advantage for your print-on-demand business. Okay, I create a lot of content on print-on-demand, to like different t-shirt ideas, but then also too, just print-on-demand goes further than that, just than t-shirt, there's different ideas for if you're designing for flyers, right? If you're designing for a book, you're creating your first book, Kindle Direct Publishing, or even you're just selling it on your own website, there's bigger than that, right? Just creating a t-shirt design, right? So if you come over here, we're gonna go ahead and just copy and paste that prompt. And then also too, if you don't like it, you can just literally just have it regenerate another one. So it's literally just simple, just create another prompt. Right? Create another idea, right? It's literally that simple. Okay, so don't think you just have to stick to the first one that it gives you. You can literally just have it create another prompt for you, then it'll generate another whole different prompt for you, okay? So watch, right? So a different idea, we can even test both of them out if you want, but we'll just go over here and then we'll go ahead and generate the image. Right now, look how cool that is. Okay, so I generated that one. It came out really clean. Look how cool that is. And you can see how the detail, as far as look at the effect around the shoe, the lighting on the shoe, the background, it's pretty clean, right? And it is. And if you're looking at this one, you wanna create another one, you just go ahead and hit generate again, give you an idea, and then we'll go ahead and use the other prompt that it created for us. All right, look at that, look at this. If you look at just the ground, the background, then you have like silhouettes of individuals in the back, right? It's pretty clean, really nice. All right, so we're just saved with those ones, and then let's go back over here to the actual prompt area, and then we'll go over here into ChatGPT, grab the other one that it created for us, copy, come over here, go ahead and then just paste it into there, and then we'll go ahead and hit generate. Dang, this one's just like next level. See that? Okay, the lighting, the ground, you see all that? That's really clean. Okay, let's go ahead and generate another one. Right, look at that. There's the lighting on this one too, just the effects, okay? I think it just created four different like unique images, okay? Now obviously this is up in there, this is up in there, this is on the ground, this is on the ground, but as far as looking at the backgrounds, have individuals here walking in the background here. This one is more up in the air looking at the skyscrapers, but this is a little bit more, added more detail to it. Now this one right here, the lighting is just bouncing off the buildings and bouncing off the ground, but also too, if you look around the shoe, it's clear there, and then you're getting more of the actual shoe itself. So the background and the shoe, it goes hand in hand on this one. This one right here, more of that neon yellow effect, but still a lot of detail to the shoe and then just the background, right? So it's clean, right? This is really nice. I'm getting a lot of technology vibes from here just because of the lining and stuff like that on the ground. And then just the outside of the light up shoes. Come on, man, this old school, right? As far as like light up shoes. I know when I was a kid, I had light up shoes, which is pretty cool. So I'm getting those type of vibes too, which is really awesome. So this is really cool. I like this a lot. I like what we did. We created right here, something different. Now, this is just like an ad for a shoe, right? Now, if you wanna switch it out, let's say you wanna put like a t-shirt, maybe something like that, or even some pants, or even you're doing some type of ad for a product that you want to sell, this is a good idea to actually do that, to just drive that attention to the product. So just think of different ideas. So if you're running like a Facebook ad or Instagram ad, or you're doing stuff on TikTok and you want to drive traffic to that image or that product, this can be a good way to create a really unique background and messing with it, right? So there's a lot that can be done with this right here. All right, so we got a fresh artboard right here. We're gonna go ahead and do something like more photorealistic, right? Now we did something like for an ad. Now let's go ahead and do something like photorealistic, and then we'll go ahead and see how that works. And I'm just curious to see. So we're over here in ChatGPT, and this is another GPT that I'm using. So what I'm gonna do is just something right here. So when you open up these, this is a Flux Prompt Pro. Okay, so this should work really good for us right here. So I'm gonna help me generate a prompt for a photo. I'm just gonna click on this right here. Portrait using Flex. Okay, this is good because we're getting into like more of a detail. Customize options. Okay, so I just wanna go ahead and put man, say green eyes. Let me just put this information here. So I'm pretty sure it'll correct it in there for us here. Put long hair. Okay, skin tone. Let's do the medium skin tone. Serious, thoughtful. That's too smiling. Background, indoor studio. Let's do natural environment. We'll do that. And then boom, everything's good. And then into the prompt. Then it should go ahead and do all that for us. Boom, it did it all, which is really nice. And all we're gonna do is right here, hit this, let it finish. Okay, go ahead and copy that. And then we're gonna come right over into Kittl. Over here to Flex 1.0 Pro, and then just paste it. And then let's go ahead and generate this and see what it does. And then we're gonna come back over here. Let's go ahead and say, create me another one with a woman. Okay, it went and did it. Now you can go ahead and change. If you created the same exact one, so do you want, I'll just leave it like that. Okay, now you wanna go into more detail, you can go ahead and add the clothing, accessories, hair color, you can do all that stuff, but I'm gonna, for the sake of this video, I'm gonna go ahead and keep it simple with just generating a woman, so we can go ahead and see how that everything works over here within Kittl. And boom, crushed it. Clean, it did everything really good. Just look at that, that's crazy. Okay, let's go ahead and generate another one. Eyes are on point, smiling. Now the next thing I'm doing is just like creating like faceless content with this, right? Plug it into like clean AI. I'm just thinking different ideas, what it can come up with. Okay, it generated another one. Let's go ahead and this is what we're gonna do. Okay, so it seemed like it generated the same one, right? Let's go ahead and generate one more, let me see what it does. Because there's certain tools out there that you can actually get these lips moving. Okay, you see what it did right there, right? It's up to you how you want it. Pretty much created the same one, which is cool. There's a lot that can be done with this, right? I'm looking at this, this is really good. Okay, so let's go back over here. So we're gonna just go back. We're gonna go ahead and clear this. We're gonna go ahead and grab the, and I was saying, I'd go back on that, the faceless content, you can literally just grab the lips, plug it into a software, and they'll start talking, and then you can literally just create faceless content online just by doing that. But this is a perfect example, because I'm getting that type of vibe when you're looking at how clear, how detailed, how realistic it looks. You're plugging this in and then having the image move, you're just taking it up to that next level, okay? That's what I'm getting from that. Now, let me come over here to this one. Let's go ahead and grab that same exact one. Go ahead and plug it in. We're plugging the same exact thing, but this time it should generate a woman for us. So let's go ahead and see how that goes. And boom, look at that. Looking good, looking good. Let's go ahead and generate another one to see what it does. It seems like it's changing up the position. You can see, you can look at the man, right? You can see how it's changing up like the position, the skin tone. He looks like he has more detail into. There we go. So the green eyes, everything's on point. The smile, the lips, the facial hair. Okay, let's generate one more. It's gonna take up all my credits over here with this. Let's go ahead. Okay, now it's showing, it's emphasizing more of the hair in this one, which I like a lot. See like the long hair, smiling still, right? This is good. This is really good. This is cool, okay? I'm not sure if you guys seen any of the AI models. It's definitely a way of creating content as far as different ways of monetizing. You can definitely do that, AI models, and have them talking people. And people are watching that, right? When people watch it, there's views and there's monetization involved. You can definitely do something like that. But this is really cool. The background, the lighting. When you're looking at this right now, look at the lighting, and you can see like the hair in the light, which it makes it even more realistic, okay? The little detail work I'm looking at, especially with this too. Look at the man in the back. Look at the hair. You can see like the lighting actually looks like the sun is like on his hair, but the light is going through the hair, right? So which gives it that effect, and it makes it more realistic, which is crazy, okay? So this is pretty cool. So this is, you can see the detail work here. This is really amazing. Now let's go ahead and create images for the storybook and see how it does. All right, so we went ahead and cleared our artboard here. Now I'm gonna go ahead into ChatGPT. Now we're just gonna freestyle here. Now we're just gonna feed it some information where I'm creating a storybook about a rabbit meeting a turtle and becoming friends and doing things together. Can you give me an outline of this book? And I would need prompts for the pictures inside of this book. It will be a short one. Enter. Okay, let's see how this does. Let's see what we got. Okay, so it's creating the whole story for us, but my main focus is here, right? This everything else just for fun, right? But I want to come in here and grab the illustration prompt, okay? And let me just go ahead, grab this, see how it does. So we're gonna come over here into Kittl, over here to Flux Pro. Let's go ahead and see how it does. Generate an image. Okay, how many scenes do we have? 3, okay. Nice, we have 6. Okay, then I'll go ahead and generate a curious rabbit. Now you come over here, we'll go ahead and generate every single prompt and then we'll go over every single one, okay? Rosie is the rabbit. Okay, and we come over here into this, right? So this is still pretty cool. Look at this dog, T-Dog, that's clean, I love it. That's just super clean. Let's go back now. Rosie's the rabbit, okay? Rabbit, for the sake of this, we will keep that out, okay? Rabbit. Rosie's a rabbit, and then Toby is the turtle. I can even go into the prompt word, tell it, just say, keep it. Let me see. And then obviously with the characters, right, you wanna keep them all the same throughout the whole book, but this is just an example of different images that it's creating. So get the whole concept, get the idea behind it and what we can do and what it can possibly create. Now, of course, through a storybook, you wanna make sure you have everything correct, everything all lined up correctly before we do anything, right? So rabbit. And then turtle. So let's go ahead and generate that one. This is just some really good images and we're just leveraging and see how it's creating and see how powerful it is. And like just the different, as we're spitting in different ideas into it, how well it's doing the prompts for us, pretty clean. All right, the last one, so cool. My mother-in-law is a big fan of rabbits and she loves rabbits. She has a pet rabbit. She takes care of them like a little kid and it's pretty cool to see how she takes care of them. And just, I never seen anybody take care of a rabbit so good. I'm looking at this and I know she would love this. I'm just sharing it with you guys. She would love this. I'm going to generate that. Now, I did this on purpose because of the different scenes, the different ideas that we're getting from here, okay? And this is so cool, okay? You can see how it goes from, and I'll enhance everyone. So it goes from here, okay? The first one was just meeting as new friends, right? That's the main idea. They're meeting as new friends. You can see that, which is really cool. You can see just looking like the background, okay? Look at the detail in the water. Like the ground is so realistic. The turtle, it looks really good. And then the bunny with the little hair, that's pretty cool. And the different flowers, right? The clouds in the back, so cool. All right, and then the next one, we come over here, the first conversation, you kind of see the bunny's feet are in the water somewhat, right? And then the turtles in the water too, and they're just sitting side by side next to each other, and it looks like they're trying to have a conversation. Pretty cool, right? Now obviously you can go into a little bit more detail of tweaking the prompt, right? Because it's just, I'm just testing this out to see how it works and giving you a better idea of how everything works. Next is discovering their differences. You can see right here, this is the one right there, that was the third one. Okay, see that sprinting, the rabbit looks like it's running, the butterfly and the turtle and the flowers, which is pretty cool. And the detail how they put, like, it actually looks like the rabbit is like sprinting, right? Which is pretty cool. So did a good job there. And helping each other, next one. And this one, I believe it is, right? So this right here, just looking at the actual detail of it, it's like looking through they're like in the bushes or something like that, moving around, it looks, and they're looking up at each other and trying to get through the bush. That's what I'm getting with it. I can see right here, the little leaves and stuff. Pretty cool. The next one, let's see, adventures together. I may have mixed that up. I forgot right there. May have mixed that up, but looking at this too, look how cool this one is. Look at the detail work on this, the sunset in the back and then the flowers and then they're sitting next to each other. Pretty cool. Okay, the rabbit is a different colored rabbit, two-tone rabbit, which they got that down pretty well. And then the actual turtle itself. Awesome. And then this one right here, it seems like this one would be like the moral of the story. And you can see like it's more of a cartoonish style, right? Compared to these ones more. This one was like a little cartoony. This one's a tiny bit cartoony, I feel, but still has like the photorealistic to it. And then these ones too as well, just like realistic photos, okay? This one's more of the cartoonish one out of all of them. This one too is very similar. This one's like pretty close, but this one has more of that flat type of, not detailed in the background, so it's more cartoony to me. And you can see like the rabbit's actually touching the turtle, right? And there, but there's a little extra foot right there. But it got it down pretty good. You can go, you probably would take that out right there. Pretty simple, right? But it got it down pretty good. You have flowers, the butterfly, right? Realistic. The bunny's cute, the turtle's cute, it's really cool. So you can see how I leveraged ChatGPT, brought it in over here into Kittl, the image generator, the Flux 1.1 Pro, and just literally came over here, started getting to work, different art boards, different styles, different looks. You can use it for ads, just how to generate a story with it, just different concept, different ideas. The realistic part of the actual images itself, like as far as humans, you can plug this into a clean AI, make your own photo realistic, where your images start to move, which is really awesome. So there's several different ways that you can use this, and you can see how I used it. My link is gonna be down below in the description of this video if you wanna sign up with Kittl AI or just Kittl in general and test it out for yourself. It's a really awesome tool to use, and you can use it to your advantage in different ways, different ideas, different concepts. It is amazing. And if you wanna see how I do the whole research process for a t-shirt design and leverage Kittl, watch this video right here next. Thank you very much for watching. Peace out.